Over in the U.S., the Biden administration will end its COVID emergency declarations on May 11. Since 2020, the public health and national emergencies have enabled hospitals and nursing homes in the U.S. to respond more flexibly when faced with COVID surges. The U.S. government has been paying for COVID-19 vaccines, some tests and treatments under the public health emergency declaration. When it expires, those costs will be transferred to private insurance and government health plans. States will be given 60 days' notice before ending the public health emergency. Here at home, the country's top health official defends the retention of the alert level system in the Philippines, despite an improving COVID situation. Speaking to ANC's Head Start, Health Officer in Charge Maria Rosario Vergere says it's meant to guide Filipinos on how to live with COVID.
We would now want to change the mindset of our Filipino people, yeah. Where you know that there is this alert level system, so you know the risk in your area. Mm-hmm. And local governments should be capacitated to provide safeguards for their constituents. So then restrictions would be removed. It's only the alert level system to stay. It's just like the typhoon signals. We need to have people be informed of what's happening across the country in terms of COVID-19. It's just something that we would like formally agreed on by the members of the IATF na madikopol na natin yung restrictions para magkaroon na ng moving on mindset din ng mga Pilipino.
Asked if she's ready to become health secretary, this is her response.
Well, right now, I think based from this 6 months or more, I am ready. I am ready, but the hesitancies are there. But sa tingin ko, pakakailangan ako ng Pilipino.
In other news, the chairman of the Philippine Senate Committee on Migrant Workers belies claims the family of slain Filipino worker Julie Biranara has accepted blood money or is considering settlement with the camp of her alleged killer in Kuwait. Our correspondent Nico Bagsik filed this report.
Of slain OFW in Kuwait, Julie Biranara will not settle the case nor will accept blood money from the camp of the family of her alleged murderer. This is according to Senator Raffy Tulfo, head of Senate Committee on Migrant Workers, who made the statement after speaking with Biranara's family last night. The issue of possible settlement has made the rounds over on social media, but the Biranara family is keen on upholding justice for their slain family member.
Yung magkaisa po ang boses silang lahat, yung father, mother, at saka yung mister, na they will not accept blood money. The exact word of the father is dugo sa dugo. Ibig sabihin, hustisya. Buhay kapalit ng buhay. So, kung ang parusa ay bitay, bitay, so be it. At hindi sila makikipag-areglo.
Also called the public to stop spreading wrong information about blood money which was allegedly received by the Biranara's family because those were false accusations. Among other politicians and government officials who visited Biranara's wake in Las Piñas yesterday were President Marcos Jr., who promised to talk to the Kuwaiti government on improving the protection of OFWs there. Senator Bongo and Secretary for Migrant Workers Toots Ople also visited yesterday.
We are also scheduling bilateral meetings with Kuwait to look at the agreement that we have, to see if there are any weaknesses in the agreement that allowed this to happen, and to make sure that those weaknesses are remedied so that the agreement is stronger and will be more supportive of our workers, and furthermore that we hope this will never happen again.
Other families, friends, and relatives of Biranara family continue to come to the wake of Julie B to send their condolences. Security remains strict at the wake following Biranara's request for privacy during this time of grieving.